Welcome by this new Rosa Photo tutorial. Today we're going to talk about the rule of thirds applied by Steve McCurry. Some people think the rule of thirds is only for the beginners, but it isn't, because the rule of thirds is actually applied by all great photographers. So I bring you to my screen so we can analyze some photos of Steve McCurry. So let's explain in 15 seconds what the rule of thirds actually is. Suppose this is your frame. You divide your frame by two horizontal lines and two vertical lines, and that's basically what the rule of thirds is, because you create four intersections, and according to the rule of thirds you have to place your main subject in one of those intersections. So that is the rule of thirds. Let's check some photos of Steve McCurry to see how he applies this rule. So this first photo is, well, like a lot of his work, made in India. And what you can see here is a beautiful man, and what you see is also the rule of thirds is applied. The face of the man is in one of the intersections, but most interestingly in this photo is also this part. So the vertical line is still there, and what you can see is that the main person, the main subject, gets most space in the photo. So two-thirds of the photo is filled by the main subject, and then one-third, it is, well, less important in this photo, still an important part because of this hand, but it's less important than the man. So the least important part gets one-third in the frame, and the important man gets two-thirds of the frame. And that is exactly what he applies also in this photo, because of course this is the main subject of the photo, so two-thirds for the main subject, one-third for the rest. So that's also a good way to apply the rule of thirds. So it's not only about placing the main subject in an intersection, it's also about dividing your frame by giving the main subject a bit more space than the rest. So in this photo, the rule of thirds is also applied. The main subject is here. Usually what a lot of photographers do is they place the main subject in the middle of the frame, and that's what why the rule of thirds is there, to avoid that. So what you can see, it is placed on this vertical line, and basically two intersections are on the subject. So also in this photo, the rule of thirds is applied. If you look at this photo, there are different composition rules applied, but the rule of thirds is also there because the main subject, the building, is there in one of the intersection. So that's also a great example how Steve McCurry applies the rule of thirds in his photographs. In this photo, the same thing. The woman in the front, she is exactly in one of the intersections, but also here in the background you can see that the subject of the background is also in an intersection. And that's what Steve McCurry does a lot. He always makes sure that the background is interesting enough, and usually you can see another subject in the background too. And if you analyze his photos, often the subject in the background is also in one of the intersections of the rule of thirds. You can also see it in this photo. The train is not in the middle of the frame, but more to the right. So it is actually in this intersection, but also the Taj Mahal in the background is in the other intersection. So this is another great example of adding an interesting background subject, and he places it in another intersection also. In this photo, the woman in the front, she is exactly, her face is exactly in the intersection of the rule of thirds. This woman in the background is not in the intersection, but her shadow is, and I think the shadow of this woman here in the wall is a very nice detail of the photo. So also this is a great example of adding an interesting background subject that works very well together with the subject in the foreground. Another way of applying the rule of thirds is by using the horizontal lines. The main subject of this photo are the bicycles, And the bicycles are in the lower horizontal line. So that's also a good way to apply the rule of thirds. And usually the horizontal lines of the rule of thirds is used by landscape photography, for example, by placing the horizon in the lower line or in the upper horizontal line. But I think this is also a great example that you can use it in a different way, in this way, by placing the main subjects on the one of the horizontal lines. And then we go to the last photo. In this photo, it seems like the rule of thirds is not applied. So if you look at this, you see there, there is nothing in the intersections, nothing interesting. Actually, the people here is a subject that stands most out in this photo, but they're not in the intersection. But what you can see very clear in this photo, with those two horizontal lines, is that the top of the stairs are on this horizontal line, and here you see exactly the same. And of course that is no coincidence, because Steve McCurry is a great photographer. So also this is a great example of using the rule of thirds. So what you can see, the rule of thirds can be applied in different ways. Sometimes you place the main subject in one of the intersections, sometimes you play around with the vertical or the horizontal lines of the rule of thirds, and as you can see, it can lead to great photographs. So the rule of thirds is not only for beginners, also apply it yourself, because it makes your photos better. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, because more videos are coming soon.